Hey everyone, what's up? It's Sam. I'm here in our studio, and welcome to what will be the first of hopefully many FAQ videos. We're basically going to be taking a lot of the questions that we get online through our contact form or in the Revv community, and just walking through and just kind of teaching everyone a little bit about what our gear does and what it's based on and all that stuff. By far, one of the most common questions we still get is, what are the G-Series pedals based on? So we're going to take a look at that today. For anyone who might not know, the G-Series pedals are in fact just based on the channels on the Generator 120 amplifier. A lot of people ask if it's based on other amps, and they are not, but they are intended to basically be a smaller format version of what our amp channels can achieve. We wanted to do this just because it's more affordable, it's more compact. You know, if you have a single channel amplifier that you like, or if you can't use a full-size head, this is just an easy way to be able to get those sounds in that format. You can use them as a preamp. We generally recommend running them in the front of the amplifier for the best results, but they can be used as a preamp as well. It is worth noting that the G-Series pedals are based on the Mark II version of the generator, and we're using the Mark III generator today. So I've got the Generator 120 here. We're going to be walking through the channels on that. And I'm using this Schecter US Nick Johnson model. This is one of our favorite guitars in the shop here. So let's take a listen. We have the G2, which is based on the second channel, the green channel, the G3, which is the first pedal we put out and is still our best-selling pedal, which is based on the purple channel, which is the third channel. And then we have the G4, which is the red channel, which is the fourth channel. So what are the differences with these? Well, the G2 is a little less gainy than the high gain channels. It's more based on like a classic type drive sound. Again, they're not based on anything, but it is more in the realm of the gain structure you'd expect from like a Marshall or something like that. Anything from kind of mid gain, even like country kind of twangy broken up tones up to like kind of like a hot rod and Marshall type tone, G2 is going to be for you. The G3 was the first pedal we put out. It's based on the purple channel. It is high gain, as is the G4, but the G3 is a little bit more modern, a little bit more mid-focused, tighter low-end response. So if you're a fan of like modern high gain tones, kind of like prog tones or like really tight down-tune type tones, that's going to be the pedal for you. And the G4 is a similar amount of gain to the G3, but it's got a little bit more low-end sag. Generally, we say, you know, if you're a fan of a 5150 type sound, you'll probably like the G3. If you're a fan of a G4, probably into like more recto type sounds, a little bit more low-end sag, a little bit more mid-range scoop. So we're just going to step through each and we're going to compare them to how they sound versus the actual amp channel itself. So first up, we'll take a look at the G2. Obviously, with EQ on the pedal, there's a lot of different range in terms of what you can hone in on. I've just kind of dialed some sounds that I like on the pedals and on the amp channel and EQ'd them similarly just so you can hear a direct comparison as to what they sound like. So first up, we're going to take a look at the G2. So we're just running into the clean channel on the Generator 120 for this. So that's our clean tone. This is going to be the G2 with the red aggression. So there's three aggression stages on each pedal, kind of progressively adding a bit more saturation. I really like using the red aggression on pretty much all of them just because of the way it saturates. You know, you can roll back the gain if you want a little bit more clarity, but just having that little extra push on all of them really sounds nice. So here's the G2. So, you know, nice rock tone, nice kind of like punk rock tone. But even using that same setting, if you flip it onto the neck pickup, you can really get kind of the more classic type rock tone. So without touching anything, I'm just going to flip over to the second channel on the 120 and play kind of the same type of riffs, and you'll hear the difference there. So once again, let's pop back to the clean channel and turn on the G2. And then we'll go back to the second channel on the amplifier here. And that's pretty much it. That's how I would use those. You know, obviously, again, with the different aggression levels and the EQ, there's a lot of different possibilities there. But those are just a couple tones that I would kind of gravitate to with the G2 or the second channel. So next up, let's take a look at the G3. So as I had mentioned before, the G3 was the first pedal that we made. It's our top selling pedal still to this day. It's high gain. It's very mid forward, very tight, you know, nice tight low end response, more of like a modern high gain tone. Great for low tunings, great for just like really tight attack. Let's check it out. So this is the clean tone. I'm using the G3 on the red aggression once again. Just really like how that sounds. Clean tone, and here's your G3. So now let's flip over to the third channel on the generator, dialed very similarly EQ-wise. So yeah, lots of like low end attack is really, really tight. Nice kind of prominent mid range. Let's listen once more to just the G3 here, and let's get chuggy. Flip back to our third channel. And you know, I was saying I do like to use this mostly for a rhythm tone just because of how tight it is, but it does work quite well for a lead tone. I generally would add, you know, like for the sake of it, let's just throw in a little bit of delay, and you'll hear how this sounds for leads. Like very just, you know, clear, lots of definition. So yeah, that's the G3 and the third channel, definitely one of my favorites. So let's check out the G4. So as I mentioned, the G4 has a similar amount of gain on tap to the G3. The main difference is in the low end response and the mid range. It's got a bit more sag, a little boomier. So if you're a fan of either more classic kind of metal tones, or if you're a fan of a rectifier type sound, you'll probably get along great with the G4. So once again, we got our clean tone here. I'm gonna turn off the effects. Here's the G4. All right, so let's flip over to the fourth channel with similar settings to what we have on the G4, which is the red aggression, a little bit of a mid scoop, a little bit of high and low boost. So yeah, you can hear for leads, it's really nice because it's a little more saturated. It's got a little bit more of that mid scoop. So it's, you know, nice and warm from a lot of the single note stuff. But also, you know, for rhythm type tones, you get a lot of saturation there. So for like, you know, the quick. So that's the G4. And once more, let's go to the fourth channel. We'll be right back. pretty much it. Thanks a lot for tuning in, guys. If you have any more questions for us, you can just shoot us an email. Also, you can tune into Gear and Beer, which we do Wednesday nights. We'll be taking lots of questions, and we'll definitely be taking a lot of ideas there for, you know, topics we want to cover here. Thanks for checking it out. We'll see you next time.